A very warm welcome, everyone. In today's session, we are going to discuss how you can quickly create a watch application compatible with your Android application. We have seen a lot of blogs and we couldn't find one of the finest resources where you can quickly get a step-by-step instruction of how to create a watch application and install it on a watch device, on a practical phone, and as well as on a practical watch. So in this demonstration, we are going to cover this. So right from the beginning, let's say you have got a watch device. This is your watch device. And you have got this watch device paired with, let's say, Wear OS companion app on Android phone. You can make it compatible or install this companion app on iOS phones also. But currently, we are having this demonstration to install Android applications on a Wear OS application. A lot of developers get confused while buying the watch. So guys, whenever you're going out to buy a watch, you need to ensure that the watch is a Wear OS watch. Only then you will be able to install the applications. And now, in order to give you a quick look at how you can quickly check whether your watch is compatible with development, you can quickly go to your watch. Within your watch, at the very top, you will have the settings options. You can quickly go to settings whenever you get a new watch. You can quickly get into the system. By default, the developer options will not be available. So you need to ensure that if your watch has developer options in it, then it means you will be able to design and deploy your applications. So in order to enable the developer options, you can go to system. You can go to system. You can go to about phone. Within about phone, you can actually go to build number and you can tap 7 times on this. On tapping 7 times, you will get a message that you are now a developer and the developer options will open. So when the developer options are open, you do need to do a few things. You have to go to developer options. You have to enable this option, stay awake when charging. You also have to enable ADB debugging, Android Debug Bridge debugging, and you have to enable debug over Bluetooth. There are various options you can debug over Wi-Fi also, but I will recommend that you do debug with Bluetooth because finally your watch application, if you're making a compatible application with a mobile phone, so then it will be connected with Bluetooth and you'll be able to debug over Bluetooth also. So in this session, we will be debugging and installing applications through Bluetooth on the watch. Okay. So taking you to the current installed applications on this device, I'll quickly show you. So here, these are the applications installed on the watch currently. And now we are going to install our new application compatible with watch. So now, once you have paired your watch with the companion app on the phone, what you guys need to do, you do need to go to advanced settings. Within advanced settings, you have to enable debugging over Bluetooth. Once you enable debugging over Bluetooth, by default, you're going to get this option that the host is disconnected and the target is connected, which means you do need to have Android Studio connected with your mobile phone so that it can install application on the target watch device. Here, the host is the computer where Android Studio is installed, and target is the watch where you want to install your application. So these are the things which you need to do. So post the watch is paired, you can come to advanced setting options and you can enable debugging over Bluetooth. Now, in order to get this host connected, what you can do is either you can start a new Android Studio project or you can go to an existing Android Studio project. So I'm going to open an existing project which I have currently made. So in my downloads directory, I have a project known as MyHeart, which I'm going to run here. So we are going to open a project known as MyHeart. MyHeart is an Android application which has the basic facilities. Within this MyHeart, we have the app code here. Within this app code, I'll quickly take you to the source. We have the Java activities available over here, where I have a few pages like login activity, configure activity, and we do have the layouts available here as well. Now, by default, you all can see that when you have your Android device connected, you can quickly run your application on the Android device. but you also need to be able to install the watch application within the watch device also. So the step-by-step process would be something like, first, we are going to enable accessibility of watch here in the running devices. How to do that? You have to quickly go to terminal. You should have platform tools installed. So in Windows, whenever you install Android Studio, you're going to get platform tools installed. You can also download platform tools from internet that is available free of cost. And what you have to do is you can quickly go to platform tools. So I'll quickly get into my users directory. CD downloads. And within downloads, I have platform tools. Now within platform tools, you can see that we have a ADB facility available over here. I'm currently doing this on Mac. You can do it on Windows. The commands are same and the process is same. Now what you have to do is you have to quickly run ADB devices. Once you run ADB devices, you can see that your mobile phone is identified here in the ADB device. But now you do need to connect it so as to allow the Bluetooth facility. So what do? We do need to allow a facility, which I'm going to quickly guide you. You're going to be able to debug your applications on watch using Bluetooth via the following commands. First, we need to enable a port number 4445 or any of the ports as per your choice you can use for the ADB hub, and then we have to connect to that port. So in order to get here, we're going to write the following command /ADB/TCP. You can use any of the port numbers. I'm currently using 4445. You can use any port between 1 to 65,535. So here the port is enabled. And now what am I going to do? I'm going to ADB connect to the IP address 127.0.0.1. That is the local host, and on the port number 4445. So once you do that, you can see that you're going to get connected. Now, once you get this message connected, on the right hand side, within your pair, within your companion app, you'll be able to see that the host is now connected and the target is now connected, which means you can install applications through Android Studio to the watch. And here also, you can also see that your Oppo, this watch is an Oppo watch, and now this Oppo watch is currently being identified. Okay. Now, what are we going to do? So suppose this application is currently meant to be installed. Let's say this is the application which can be currently installed on my Samsung device only. So what am I going to do? I'm going to quickly run this application initially to show you how it looks like on the phone. And then we are going to create a compatible Android Watch app. So initially, when I'm going to start with the project, there are a few changes which I do need to do in my current project. I do need to create a bottom sheet. So allow me an option. I'll create a value in the style sheet and I'm going to call it as the bottom sheet. So you don't need to do this step. This is just the compatibility. These are some of the steps which I just need to do in my own project. You don't need to do this stuff at all. Now, the second thing which I would be doing is I would be installing some fonts which I have used. So I'm going to change those fonts here. So in my project, I do need to change these two fonts. By default, the font does not have this available. So I'm going to use Roboto Regular. Roboto Regular. I'm going to replace these fonts. So this is just the part of the application. You guys don't need to do it. So now I'm going to currently install my application on the device. And here. So you can see that the installation is in progress. And the application is successfully running on the device now. So you can see that I've got my application running on my phone, which is my heart application. Now what I want is, within this heart application, I want to read the data from my watch. So watch is going to read the data of the heart and I'm going to transmit the data from watch to the app. And in order to do the various processings. So now how we are going to do it, let us get into the second step. So how will we be making a compatible watch app? So now you have to select your project. You have to go to file and you have to create a new module. within the new module, what you have to do, you have to add a new module, and this is going to be a VROS module. Now, there are a few things which you need to understand before getting into the stuff. The first thing which you need to know is the package name, because in order to make the data transmitted between the watch and the app, you need to use the same package name. So this is a very important information which you need to follow. So what am I going to do? I'm going to go to file now, create a new module. I'm going to create a new module. I'm going to select my VROS module, and I'm going to change this application name to watch app. Let's say this is going to be my watch app. I'm going to change the package to something as the app, akvida.divanshu.tmheart is the name of my package, which I'm going to use, and followed by this. So one thing which we do need to do here is we do need to convert the project to Android X dependencies in case if you want to add the module. Sometimes it happens, let's say if you have a old project and you want to enable watch facility in it. So you do need to convert it into Android X dependencies. So how can we quickly do it? We can go to refactor, and we have to migrate to Android X. Before migrating to Android X, you do need to do a few things, which means you need to have a compile SDK set at least to 28 in order to have the watch modules running or migrated to Android X. So what I'll do, I'll quickly go to Gradle, I'll go to module app, and I'm going to change my compile SDK to 28 and the target SDK version to 28 as well. Minimum SDK version can be 25 so that we can run it on Android devices 7 and above. So now, once I've done these changes, I'm going to sync now. The configuration is successful. Now, once the configuration is successful, we'll go to refactor and we'll migrate the project to Android X. We'll keep a backup of the code with the name myheart.zip. I'm going to save it. So currently we are migrating the project from current configurations to Android X configuration so that we will be able to enable watch modules in the project. So this means in case if you have an earlier application and you want to make it compatible with your watch, you'll be able to do it. In case if you are building a new application, then generally, definitely you'll be having your compile SDK and target SDK more than 28. Now, so we got the project migrated to Android X. Now, what are we going to do? We'll quickly go here to the file and we're going to add a new module. And this module is going to be the watch module. So I'm going to create a VROS module. I'm going to name my application to watch app. I'm going to edit my package name to hackvida.divanshu.tmheart. And again, this is a very important thing which you guys need to know. You need to keep the package name of the watch app as same as the package name of your compatible mobile app. Okay, this is mandatory. Otherwise, you won't be able to transmit data between each other. Then we are going to keep the minimum SDK, let's say as Snowbird. That won't be a problem. I'll quickly proceed to next, and I'm going to create a blankware activity. Name of the activity will be main activity, and we're going to click on finish. So once we click finish, now within the current project, we're going to get a new project created with the name watch app. Okay, this is something which we're going to have. So we're going to do a few changes. I'm going to remove the box edges that is not required in my project. I'm going to go to file and I'm going to save all. Then there are a few more changes which I do need to do in the manifest file. So in the manifest file, I want to keep the launcher icon as my app's drawable icon. So this is what I'll be doing. So I'll go to the drawable and I have a few images. Let's say this is going to be the XXX HDPI image, which I'm going to use. So I'm going to copy that and I'm going to keep that image in the drawable folder within my watch also. So I'm going to paste it. The name is going to be app image in the drawable. So in the watch, I'm changing the icon currently. So I'll quickly use drawable app image. This is going to be my name of my, the icon of my application. Then the label will be watch app. So it's going to be displayed as watch app. The default activity is going to be main activity and the name is going to be watch app. Okay, WhatsApp is going to be the name of my application, followed by within the layout, within activity main.xml, I do have a title with a string hello world, and I'm going to change this to something like Devanshu Heart App, or I can change it to my company's name. Let's call it as Hack With Us Heart App. So this is going to be displayed. This is going to be the text content which is going to be displayed, and it will look something like this. I'll show it to you on the watch itself. So I'm going to file, save all. So I've got a few changes done here. Similarly, I want to do the changes in my manifest application also for my main app. So I'm going to change the icon to drawable app image, and the name of my application will be My Heart, let's say. So within my phone, I'm going to show my application name as My Heart, and within Watch OS, it is going to be known as Watch App. So Wear OS, it's going to be known as Watch App. So these are the two things which we do need to do in order to make the application. So now we will be able to install the application on the phone. Okay, so that's our Watch App. I have done save all. There might be a few changes which we do need to do, which includes we have to enable Wear services sometimes in case if there is an error. Suppose if you get an error, something like fail to install shared library, in case if you get an error like that, we can do it by adding some dependencies within your Gradle. So I'm going to show you the error first, and then I'm going to show you how you can enable that facility. So now you can quickly select if you want to install the app. You can install it on Samsung SGF5, which we have already done. Now you can see within edit configurations, you will automatically get the Watch App which we are creating. So once you select the Watch App, you have to select on which device. So now you are getting Oppo Watch, and we are getting this Oppo Watch because we have already connected it with the companion app, and we have access to the app now, to the watch now. So I'm going to quickly run it and install the application. In case if we get an error of installation of the shared library, fail to install the shared library, we are going to install those. Okay, so now okay, it says the application could not be installed due to the device is offline. So what are we going to do? We are going to connect it again. Let us just quickly see the ADB devices. I'm going to connect it again, and I quickly see the devices again. Okay, I'll just enable it. So now, just a second, let me just remove it. Okay, so let me just run it. So the application is currently being installed. You can see that the installation process begun. So there might be only an issue of the shared library. In case if you get a message like fail to install the shared library, then in that case, we can install Play Services. So now you can see that the application is currently installed, and you can see that Hack With A Heart App is now running here on my device. So you can see that we're getting this message, Hack With A Heart App. Now what I can do is I can quickly go back and I can go to the applications. When I go here in the applications, you can see that at the very last, I get this heart icon, which is my apps icon. So I'll quickly take you there. So once I click on this heart icon, you can see that this is Hack With Us Heart App. And similarly, if I go back to my applications here, in my device, which is the Android device, if I quickly take you to the menu, so I'm going to rerun this application, the watch on my Samsung SGF5, and I'm going to rerun. Once I rerun, this icon on my mobile phone will also change to the heart icon with the name of the heart application. So the installation is in progress. And we got the app running. And if I take you again, so you can see that we have got the application MyHeart running. So that's all for this video. In the next video, we are going to show you how you can transmit, how you can create a Heart application within Watch, and how you can transmit that Heart data to your mobile phone and do the processings. Thank you so much for watching.